Hello creative designers and welcome once to the tutorial. My name is Peter. And on today's tutorial, we're just going to learn how to add this login pop-up button. When you click on it, just the login button just pop up. And I'll also show you how to add the register button. When customer click on register button, the register form will just pop up. Customer also, you just need to fill on this form. And I'm also going to show you how to redirect to a certain page. And after the customer just managed to either log in or just request the password, you have the even the lost password form. Customer, you also need to just enter the username and the reset link will be set. And once the customer managed to either log in or register, will be directed to the dashboard. And this is the menu for the dashboard. It will have my account panel like this. It will have the username, which will say hello username, whichever, either the last or the first name or the username. And it will also have this logout button. We're just going to use a free plugin for us to achieve all this, and I'm going to take you step by step until we achieve this final result. My name is Peter. Welcome to my channel. Remember to subscribe to this YouTube channel. We do deal with WordPress related tutorials. Without further ado, let's just get into action and I'll show you how we do it. Thank you. So the first thing we need to do, we need to get the dashboard. And on the dashboard menu, scroll to where you have the plugin. We need to install the plug that we are going to use in this tutorial. It's a free plugin. So on hover on the button for the plugin, you have these three options. Select the second option, add new plugin. Come here and search for login for slash sign up pop-up. You have so many options here, but the one you're going to use is from Exotic. Yeah, you can see the name is login sign up pop-up inline form plus WooCommerce. It will just offer you some more options when you're using WooCommerce. You can see out of 88 rating, it has more than 5 stars. It has also more than 10,000 active installation and last updated 2 months ago. So we install the plugin. After successful installation, we activate the plugin. After the successful installation, you can see now we have the button, and on hover we have the setting and we have the field. So we click on it. You can see the first option that we are going to receive is all this for the setting. You have the general settings, style, advanced, and info, and they are also giving you some add-on. You can opt to purchase them and use them in your website. So we are going to start with the general setting. Here in the general setting, in this option, you can also manage the registration field. On opening, you have this the field that are available. Yeah, they are locked. You cannot be able to delete them, but you can move them like that. You can decide to interchange them. You have that option. So we start the general setting. The first field is the first button is for registration field. In this, you'll be able to manage the field that are available in the registration form. The other thing is you enable the registration. Do you want this form to have the registration? Yeah, I hope to have it. Auto login user or sign up. Yeah. Let the button remain on. Hard reset password. Once you have this button checked, it will allow your user to request their password by themselves. The other thing is the user role. What are the role you want to allow when you have a new member using this form to register? I want them to be a customer. You can decide to have them as subscribers, contributors, or even shop manager. You can select from the options here. But for now, I just want to have the customer. The other thing is login redirect. After the login, which page do you want to redirect? Let me just open this. If you want to direct to either shop or whichever the page you want to direct, you just have to copy the link like that. Let me just copy the shop. So here you have the link. I copy that. And I need to come here to the setting and login redirect. You paste the shortcode, you paste the link here, And after successful login, customer or whoever just use the form to login will be directed to that page. That's how it works. You can opt to leave it empty if you want it to redirect to the same page. The other thing is register direct after successful registration. Which page do you want to redirect? You can say to maybe my account or whichever you want. You want. Let me first of all choose for my account like that, and I copy like that, and I paste the link there. After the logout, you can enter the redirect. From here, you can replace my account form. Yeah, you can direct to replace this my account form here with the one that is going to be given by the plugin. Replace checkout login form. You can also opt to check, but I would tend to leave them the way they are. Open, auto open one pop up. You can select on whichever page. Maybe if someone lasts for some few seconds in a certain page, the form will just pop up. I'm not going to set that, but if you want to set that, you still have the option. You need to select the page here. So you need to come here and say maybe home, enter the comma like that, and you just save it. What does it mean? So if someone opens homepage for a few seconds, it should the form should pop up. So let's try and see. We open this link in a, let me copy this and I open it in a private page. So you can see the form will just pop up, and one thing customer need to either log in or sign up. That's how it works. You want this form to open to a certain page, all you need to do is you come here and enter the page. So you need to enter the page name here and enter the comma, and the thing you need to set is the time here. So I've put 5 seconds and you save it. Just that, once you open this page in an incognito window or the private window or whichever new page, and you paste, you just give it like that, and after 5 seconds you see it just open up. Customer, you just need to enter like a login credential and click the sign in, or you have the sign up form. You can see how the sign up form look like. You have the username, email, first and last name, password, and confirm. Those are the fields that were available here. Remember here the registration field. Here you had them, we had the username, email, just like that. You see we have the username, email, first and the last name. Here we have the password, confirm password, terms and conditions. So customer need to click here for the sign up to go through. So from there, now we get back here. We go to style. Which position do you want it to pop up? I just want it in the middle. You can increase the width and the height. I don't know how much you can set from there. You can also set the background color. You can see the time. For now, let me just open a private window. Just want us to do it practically. So you can see the background color, whether for the login or the sign up, is white. You can say to have a different color, something like that. You can say to have the way you want it. There's the background color, the text color. You can select the one you want. The side image, this one. Let me squeeze like this. This ID image, you can decide to change it. You can select another image if you have one. I will just select one of them, and we just start the next, the sidebar. It's on the left side. You can see here, it's on the left side. You can decide to have it on the right side. So, and you can also increase the sidebar width to something like even 50 or 60. And from there you save it. Let's refresh the page here. You can see the background has changed, and you can see even the image has changed. It's all upon you. You can decide to have it, you can decide to remove it. You can also decide to have it on the light side, and you can also even decide to have it the small size like that, or you need to spray with the setting and see which setting suits you. Yeah. So for now, like the setting you have just added, just need to refresh. Let's come here and refresh here. You can see it has just moved to the right, and you can see the width has been minimized to small size. It's all upon you to play the setting and set the way you want. Let me just use like something like 40, the width was. And I also select the image that was. I have lost the image, but you can set to have the one you want. From there, now you have the form. You can set the background for the form, and you can have the background tab color. Yeah, you can set the form here. We have the tab color. You can set to have different tab. This is the tab itself. Let me refresh. So once you open here, like when you just want to type like that, you see it just get darker more than the other one. So you can say to change the color here the way you want it to. Active background color. You can say to have the text color, active text color. Button design, you can use the themes or the color. You can use the one that available. Let's try to use the one for the theme. You can see even it has changed. Yeah, the active one. Yeah, the tab background color. And the active one, you can see the active one is black. And tab text color, you can say to have the color is white. The one that is active, but the one which is not active, you can say to have another color. You can say to choose one. It's all for you to play the setting and have something that will look good. So from there, button background color, you can say to change all these, and button text color. Let's first of all setting, and we refresh here. You can see we have changed. I've changed back to white. So button text color, this one, and the button border. You can say to play the setting, and you just when you set everything just that. You can even decide to have a different text color. Have something like yellow. Button background, you can say to have something different like that. And after that, you set the setting, refresh the page. So from there, you come to the form field. You can come inside to change the form field style. So you need now to come here and set the field. So you can decide to show these icons here. You can decide to show them, or you can decide to hide them. You can also decide to increase the icon size to something like, let's say put something like 20, and you set the setting, and you refresh the page here, and you're able to see the size of the icon increasing. Let's see, you can see they are larger more than they were. You can decide to have something like 30 or 40. I don't know if it can go beyond the field. Let's try and see. Let it refresh here. You can see they have increased in size to this maximum, the one you have set. So I want something like 10 or 15. Icon container width, this size here. You can also try to increase. Icon background color, you can say to change the background color to something, okay, whichever you want to use. And from there, we have the icon color. You can say to have something like that, red. Border, you can say to have a different color, and you have to input field background color. This field's now here. You can say to have different color. So you can see for now it's white. You can say to have something dull like that. Input text color, I want it to be black. And input focus. Can't select something like that. And after that, I save the setting. So I need to refresh the page for us to see the difference. You can see it has changed. So once you click on it, just change the color. Input focus background color. Once you just highlight this, just change it. And you just need to start typing. So let's find input text color. Let me use white like that. And let's save the setting. So let me refresh here. So you see how it is typing. So it's all upon you to play the setting here and achieve to that milestone, achieve to that best quality pictures you want, quality form you want. So I need to get back to input. I need to put this one is white and focus a little bit like that and save the setting. Let's see how it will look like. To me, I would prefer to have it the way it is for now. I would wish to have the focus color like that. Yeah. Once customer clicks here, you know what is here typing. So you can also decide to have it faded like that. You can play with the setting and achieve a good result more than the one I'm just showing. So from there, let's refresh for the last time and see. You see, it's not the way it was, so dark. So customer can be able, or you can also decide to have a different color. So let's get back to field. Let's get back to setting here. So we had already done with the general setting. Now we are in style. We have just set the style. We go to advanced. If you have your own custom CSS, you can just input them here and you click the save. I'm not going to add the CSS for now. And here they are also offering the way you can just create your own shortcode. They are giving you the way you can do it. So, but we're not going to create a shortcode for now. Let me show you how you can add this, all these we have just added, the features that we have just added. We just want them here. So when you open like home and you're logged in, should show the username and so forth. So we need to go to appearance, scroll to where you have menu. On the menu section, now you have this login sign up pop up. On click on the drop down, you can see it has so many features. So I wish to select the login button. I also wish to have the register button, the lost password button, and for the logged in, I also have to have the logout button. And I also want to have hello username. I'm not used to use hello username because some people may not like to use the username, but you can say to have username or the first name. And you have my account for the logged in users. And just that, I need to click add to menu. So we had the other my account. I wish to delete this one. So now here we have the login, logout, login, yeah, let it be here. The register, let it be the last one, yeah. So hello user, let it be on. Because these are going to be available, logout, let it be here, or like that. So I'll have my account and hello username. Yeah, let it be the last one, like that. That's how I would wish to arrange them. I have the login, register, logout, hello username, and my account. So once I save it here, I refresh. The best thing about this plugin is that Once you don't have to set more features like when you're logged in, you'll be able to see this. When you're logged out, no, it doesn't show that. It just gives you the option to. So on click, you have now we have the menu, we have the logout, and we have Hello Admin. If you want this to be here, so what you need to do is you come here, rearrange your menu here, just like that. Just drag either upwards or downward. Click Save the setting. After you save the setting, refresh the page here. Once you refresh the page, you can see it has just changed. You have now Hello Admin, and you have the logout. You have my account. On click on my account, you see now customer, you have the dashboard, you have the orders, downloads, address, account detail. Customer can even change the account detail from here and add the name, first name, last name, email address can change. Customer has the option the way you can change the password from here and add a new password and the other way. And customer need to just click the save changes. Customer also have this logout button. The other thing I just want to show you is we open this page in a private window and we see the difference. So I'll move all this. So let's close here. Now you see we don't have my account like the way we had here. We don't have my account. We don't have hello username or even the logout button. You don't have the login register and the lost password. So you can set now this lost password to be the last one here. It will be just like that. Let it be like that. And you save the setting here. So, but this one thing I just wanted to show you. So let me close that one. And we open this page in a private window. The first way to pop up is like this. And the other thing is when you just click login, it will just pop up. Once you click register, it will just pop up and highlight the sign up button. Customer can also decide to log in just like that. Customer, you also only need to put the login. And once customer, the login credentials, once customer login, it will just get the customer to this point here where you have this menu and some of them are missing on just login. That's how the plugin works. You can see how it is very easy to use the plugin. Yeah, I hope you gained something out of this tutorial. My name is Peter. And if you did got something from this channel, remember to hit the subscribe button for more WordPress related tutorials to follow. My name is Peter and I want to say thank you for visiting my channel. Hit the thumbs up for this tutorial. Thank you.